viajeros del mundo. Somos Mónica
y David. Bienvenidos a Punta Cana. Well, good morning. Hey, David Fontana here, and we are in Punta Cana, as my wife told you in the introduction of the video. And specifically, we're at the Grand Palladium Bávaro Resort and Spa. That is a mouthful to say. It's a huge, huge hotel complex with four different hotels: the Bávaro, the Punta Cana, the Palace, and the TRS Turquesa, which is the private adult area or part of the hotel. You have access to all the hotels except the TRS Turquesa, which I get, you're paying a little bit more for that, for the privacy and exclusivity, that's right. So anyway, we are here for a week. We're gonna take you to the beach, we're gonna go to all the pools, we're gonna try out as many of the a la carte restaurants as possible. You need reservations for them. Sometimes the application's kind of finicky and it's hard to make them. I managed to get three in this morning, and give you what we like about the hotel, what maybe we don't like so much about the hotel, maybe not a bad thing about the hotel, but something that they could fine tune and they could fix it, you know, tweak it a little bit and it would be better. I'm sure we're gonna love this place. Already I'm impressed with the tropical grounds here, and it's just gorgeous. It's just gorgeous, I have to say. I'm a plant guy, so to wander through here and listen to the tropical birds and study the plants and see, oh, do I have that on my rooftop deck? I need to get that one. It's kind of fun. It's kind of fun. So enough of me talking about this introduction here. The sun's coming out. It's going to be a great day. I'm going to go wake up the wife and head to the beach, and I'll meet you there. So aside from the lovely gardens here, the grounds are just impeccable. They're beautiful. This hotel has 13 restaurants. It has 8 pools, 20 bars. So there's a lot to get in this week. We're going to try to do it all because we want to show it all to you, and we're happy that you're along with us. So before getting Monica out of bed and heading to breakfast, pro tip number one, if you want a great spot on the beach under one of the palapas, head there early. I'm talking 5:30, 6 a.m. and claim your spot. When I arrived, a German woman was already throwing down her brown towels on every chair under a palapa. But at the very last second, I snagged these two in the back for Monica and I. And remember, it's okay to claim your chairs, head off to breakfast, and come back to the beach. But be considerate, unlike the German woman, who never returned until 3 or 4 that afternoon. So after securing our spots at the beach, I woke up Monica and we started walking over to the morning buffet for breakfast. As I mentioned before, the hotel complex is huge, and it's perfectly natural in the first few days to get lost as you're trying to find your bearings. But what we found is if you followed these palm thatched walkways, the directional signs, and didn't deviate from the path, it usually led you to where you wanted to go.
And here we're arriving at the Cathedral, La Catedral, which is the buffet at the Bávaro. This is where all the guests come to have breakfast in the morning. As you can see, it's a lovely, lovely building.
Walking to the buffet kind of gave off that British colonial or Bali vibe with the teak bridges and the water running underneath. The dining room itself is absolutely beautiful.
Buenos dias, buenos dias.
I especially love the high ceilings and all the travertine marble everywhere. The buffet had a wonderful omelet station, which Monica loved. I was more into the carnivorous offerings. More bacon? Why, yes, please. There were also lots of tropical fruits to choose from, and a plethora of freshly squeezed juices and smoothies. And if the healthy start to your day is not your thing and you're more in the John Belushi camp like me, there were plenty of little chocolate donuts, pancakes, waffles, and churros. Oh, I love the churros. For lunch, there was also a buffet called the Arrecife near the beach. And for dinner, there was the Las Torres buffet, located at the Palace Hotel. But I think our personal favorite was the Bejique, located at the Punta Cana. It was smaller, but it seemed to have a more upscale selection of food than the other buffets.
At the Bejique, they had a Bloody Mary bar, Bloody Mary station. That was nice. Didn't find that at the Cathedral.
After a great breakfast and a Bloody Mary or two, Monica and I were ready to hit the beach for some fun in the sun.
All right, I got Monica out of bed and here we are at the beach. She has a new bathing suit. You like it? Yeah, you like it. And we just got back from the Lambi bar with our tumblers full of Presidente. That's the beer of Dominican Republic. Es delicioso. I have a great drink of the day. I don't even know what it's called. The guy just invented it for me. And here we are at the Grand Palladium Bávaro, which I think has the best beach out of all the hotels, all the Grand Palladiums. The Punta Cana, the beach is small, it's kind of worn away, and the Palace, which is the most expensive of the hotels, also had a very undesirable beach. One thing I will say that's great about the Grand Palladium, and I'm looking at the other resorts next to us, is they do a very good job of cleaning the seaweed. And the other hotels just leave it there, which, you know what, that's part of giving an experience to the client. The beach is part of the hotel, so you really should be maintaining that, and they do that here at the Grand Palladium.
Salud.
All right, so another little tip here, when you come down to Punta Cana and one of these all-exclusives, is to grab yourself a couple of these tumblers. These tumblers, they will fill up instead of drinking out of those 6 ounce plastic cups. You know, they'll fill those up and you gotta come back time after time. But if you come out with a little niceness, a little smile, like Coolest suggests on YouTube, I love that guy, I follow him, he's fantastic. He comes up and he says, dame la gasolina, dame su trago más genial. I love that. And they will fill it up and they will be much nicer for you. And also, another tip from Coolest is come with propina. Propina is tips, dollars. Bring dollars, come on, these people work very hard for very little. And a little goes a long way if you're a little bit nice here in Punta Cana.
Monica and I were starting to get hungry for lunch, but we didn't want to leave our spot at the beach. So we headed on down to La Uva at the Punta Cana. La Uva is kind of a quick fare fast food restaurant under a cluster of mangrove trees right along the beach. Was the food any good? Absolutely not. But with this really cool sangria station right in front of the ocean, we didn't care. And after what can only be described as an incredible first day on the beach, it was time to head back to our villa to shower and change for our first experience at one of Grand Palladium's a la carte restaurants.
All right, so the very first restaurant we're trying out here at the hotel and resort is La Paisana. This is the Argentinian steakhouse. So we're expecting some good things, steak, sausages from Argentina, and hopefully it's very, very good. It's delicious. There's 13 other restaurants. We can't eat at all of them, but we're gonna try to get in as many as we can during the week that we're here.
La Paisana had an upscale and elegant decor with a dimly lit dining room, adding to that romantic atmosphere I was hoping for at dinner with my wife.
All right, what's up everyone? Let's talk about La Paisana Noche. I didn't have high expectations. You know, you hear that these a la carte restaurants aren't that great, but you know what? It impressed the hell out of me. It was our first place that we tried here in the resort. Excellent, excellent steak, as you can see here. It was juicy. This was the sirloin steak. We got the papa puré, which is the mashed potato, and some fried pineapple. My wife got the skirt steak, which was also tender. We cut it with a butter knife, to be honest with you. And we started off with the little empanadas, fritos. They were filled with carne, like a steak type thing. And of course, all the steaks came with your typical chimichurri sauce and all that. And even the desserts were excellent. The desserts, I'm not a great fan of flan, but my wife loved it so much that she ordered two of them. And I enjoyed the little cookies. They were pretty good. But it was elegant. The service was very nice. The girl that attended us when we bought our wine, and she was all smiles. Very, very nice, which we haven't always been encountering here at the resort. The staff seems to be a little, I don't know, as they say in Spanish, amargado, un poquito, like pissed off. But it was a totally different experience last night at La Paisana. I don't know why I'm having trouble saying that word. But that was the Argentinian place. We're going to try a lot more. And right now we're about to head off off campus here to a little resort where they have horseback riding and beach and big swimming pools and all that. Her cousin lives here in Punta Cana, so she's coming to pick us up, and we'll see how that is, and we'll show you all around that place. Hopefully it's fantastic.
So while my beautiful wife was still getting ready, which is always worth the wait, I thought what better time than to give you a small tour of the hotel and grab a drink of the day at the lobby bar. Here we have the main entrance at the Grand Palladium Bávaro, which leads you into the main lobby, where you'll find plenty of comfortable seating for hanging out with a drink during a show or just waiting to check into the resort. It also has beautiful water features, an open-air roof, more plush seating, and a lobby gift shop. And I'd be remiss not to mention the lobby bar. Oops, looks like we're here a little too early. Let's continue the tour and come back for that drink of the day. Stepping outside the lobby area, it was a pleasure walking along the interconnecting teak bridges, admiring the Bávaro's impeccably manicured gardens, filled with tropical flower and fauna.
Outside, you have these lovely, Caribbean-style gift shops. If you need a suntan lotion, I don't recommend buying it here because it's like triple the price. Bring it with you. But if you need it, they have these nice little Caribbean colorful buildings where you can do a little shopping and buy things you might have forgotten or just pick up some souvenirs, things like that. And this is a cool little wine bar, like a tapas wine bar. Monique and I are meaning to try it. We haven't tried it yet, but we're gonna do it one of these days while we're here, called First Wines. And this is the sports bar, extra time sports bar here at the Grand Palladium Bávaro.
There was also a grand theater at the Bávaro for concerts and shows at night.
And I love how the restaurants are all interconnected by these lovely, lovely wooden bridges. And it kind of extends this way. And if you follow these signs, you won't get lost, and you'll find all the restaurants: the Bamboo, La Lola, Adelita, Catedral, La Paisana, Arrecife. Arrecife is the buffet, which I hear is very, very good. This is the lovely Chinese restaurant, Bamboo.
And along the way, no need to be startled, you will run into, shall I say, some of Bávaro's more exotic permanent residents. And as we continue on, we come upon Lola, which is the Spanish tapas restaurant, where Monica and I will be dining this evening. A little further down the bridge was the Mexican restaurant, La Adelita, or E La Adelita. Portofino was the Italian a la carte restaurant, and right next door was the hotel steakhouse, El Dorado. Bogali was the Indian restaurant, but it was closed during our stay. And finally, for seafood lovers, there was the Poseidon, located a little closer to the beach.
So the drink of the day is the Mojito Chinola. Mojito Chinola.
Or a passion fruit mojito.
Mm.
bueno.
So it was a long way over here, but here we are in this very unique property. It's called Tracadero. It's a resort spa with condominiums and beautiful swimming pools. It's in the Bahia area of Santo Domingo, oh, Dominican Republic, I should say. But I can't wait to see it. We're about to head in.
As you enter Tracadero, you encounter an elegant oasis made up of dozens of saltwater swimming pools. Each pool is nestled up against Bayahibe's rocky coastline, which made for a unique experience as each crashing wave replenished the pools with salt water from the sea.
So here we are in Tracadero, it's called. It's a resort about, I would say, about an hour outside of Punta Cana. We drove out here to spend the day. My wife's niece, it's her birthday, Sherry Lynn, and we're just going to have a nice time with family, drinks. The place is a private resort, but you can pay. You don't have to own a condo here or a villa. And it's filled with swimming pools, gorgeous swimming pools. The water is that electric blue, that beautiful blue water. You could swim here. It's a little rough, I think, for snorkeling. But it's well worth the visit, I would say. Well worth it. Madre! Yeah! Woo! Feliz cumpleaños. Okay.
And as the sun began to set, the Escobar lit up with tropical hues of pink and blue, beckoning me like a siren song to order another passion fruit margarita. Our whole group had the best time, and I can honestly say, Tracadero is a place that we will definitely return to. Since we were already outside the resort, we thought, why not take advantage and venture over to one of the hottest night spots in all of Punta Cana? The infamous nightclub, Cocobongo.
Here we are. The famous Cocobongo lugar,
¿verdad?
Sí,
con esas bellas mujeres y mi sobrino de Venezuela. Hola,
vos. We're gonna have a good time and we wanna show you what you can do outside of the resort sometimes. You don't have to fear and venture out sometimes.
Surrounding Cocobongo, there's a multitude of bars and restaurants to choose from. We settled in at the Viva Colombia for dinner and drinks, and you can even get a tableside shoeshine. Having so much fun at Viva Colombia, we never made it into Cocobongo that night, but it looked incredible and will definitely deserve a dedicated video of its own. The next morning was sunny and bright as usual, so we hit the beach early because we had a very special excursion planned for later that day.
All right, so Monica and I are about to head out on this party boat. It was about $130 out, something like that. We got them down to like $110. You can negotiate here on the beach. It's no problem. You should negotiate because they'll always bring the price down a little bit. And it's our first time on a party boat. We've done the catamarans to Saona, and we've done like the parasailing, but we've never done the party boat. So let's see what it's like. We'll let you know our honest opinion, whether it was worth it or not for you guys. Maybe try it out. And we're about to get on in about 10 minutes, so we'll show you. Thank you. what's up? So I want to tell you about the party boat. Man, was that worth it? That was so much fun. You get on the boat and there's open bar, no food, but it didn't matter. We had so much fun riding out there in these turquoise waters, and they take you to this natural section of the sea, the Caribbean Sea here, where you swim and do snorkeling. We saw a giant stingray go by. That was super cool, right below us. All kinds of tropical fish and the coral reefs. That was really nice. And then they also take you to a section where you get off the boat, you have your drinks, and it's shallow, so you can just party in the water, and all the other party boats gather together. So you're filled, you know, you're in the ocean with a ton of people, and everybody's in a good spirits and a good time, having a good time. And you come back dancing on the catamaran. It was just a wonderful experience. I highly, highly recommend it. I think it was only like $110 for Monica and I. I would have paid more. It was that good.
The following morning, I woke up early to head to the gym, taking my time on my walk, enjoying all the beautiful palms and tropical plants along the way. There were also beautiful sculptures to admire and a few friends to say good morning to.
Hello. You having a nice time in paradise?
On the way to the gym, I passed some of the swimming pools at the resort. This one is the swimming pool at the Bávaro. I know I promised at the top of the video that we would visit the pools, but they were underwhelming and needed updating, and didn't have a great vibe. I love pools, Monica doesn't, but we spent most of our time at the beach, so it'll have to wait for a future video. The gym was located at the Grand Palladium Palace, and it was large, spacious, and had all the equipment necessary to get a great workout in, which I was gonna need driving the boogies on our excursion later that day. And after my workout to surprise Monica after the boogies, I booked a couple massages for us at the spa.
Okay, this is for the boogie excursion. All right.
Dominicano.
The best. Okay, so we got on the wrong boogie truck. We switched over to this one, the Rex boogie, and now we should be good. We're on our way.
After about a 20-minute ride through town, we arrived at the site and got into our boogies. We then waited our turn to head off to a watering hole or cenote, and it was a good thing that we had sunglasses and masks because the dust got absolutely everywhere.
All right, so we just got off the boogies, and this is one of the stops they bring you to after you swim through a underwater cave. It's a man-made cave, but it was kind of cool. They show you how to make cigars, how they do chocolate and the coffee process, and they do try to sell you along the way, but they brought us to this beautiful beach. The water is amazing here, right? Yeah. And you know, you can't beat it with this electric blue water drinking Presidentes with the love of your life here. That's about as good as it gets. So we're gonna jump on the boogies again in a little bit, about an hour's, and this is worth it. This is worth it for sure. Okay, mi gente latino, acabo de bajar de los boogies, y aquí estamos en este playa bello con agua eléctrica azul, ¿verdad?
Hermosa.
Hermosa, con nuestros presidentes. La mejor cerveza de Dominicana.
La verdad que sí, es la mejor.
¿Y qué hicimos en los boogies?
Oh, bueno, fue una experiencia demasiado buena. Si tienes que cubrirte por el polvo, si usas lentes de contacto para ver, tienes que preferiblemente usar tus fogos. Pero de verdad, el paseo es súper genial.
Ajá.
Te lo recomiendo.
¿Y las cuevas?
En este paseo que nos ofrecieron, nos habían dicho una cueva natural, esta es construida por la mano del hombre. Sin embargo, es una experiencia diferente, pero no era lo que esperábamos. Así que pendiente con eso cuando alquilen o decidan aceptar un paquete de estos, ser bien específicos cuáles.
Yeah.
La construida por el hombre o la natural.
Fue más como un parque de agua o algo así.
Pero
fue fresco. Yeah.
Estuvo bonito.
Frescamos un poquito. Pero vale la pena manejando los buggies aquí, a este lugar tan precioso, el agua. Increíble.
Llega como un médano, cubierto de arena, pero es genial.
Recomendable.
Monica decided to drive us back, which left me just enough time for a quick stogie before the imminent dust storm.
Ahorita mi esposa está manejando. Tal vez, vamos a ver. Dame la gasolina!
The whole boogie experience was about $40 per person, and we highly recommend it. It was totally worth it, and we even got these really cool photos taken of us at the end. After returning from our excursions, we showered and changed and headed over for some well-deserved massages at the Grand Palladium's Zentropia Spa. The pool at the Zentropia was the best one at the resort. It was magnificent and so relaxing, with all its water features massaging away your stress and your anxieties. After our hour massages, which we both agreed were the best ones we had ever had, we enjoyed the rest of the afternoon hanging out by the pool and taking advantage of the different spa treatments offered by the Zentropia.
Hot and cold therapy. This is the cold plunge tub. And then you have the hot water.
There were even different kinds of showers you could try, from the bucket shower, to the rain shower, to an all-over body jet shower. Our afternoon of relaxation at the spa was the perfect culmination to our last night at the resort, and with a final sunset on the beach, it left us both with a lasting feeling of bliss and serenity that would stay with us long after our vacation ended.
All right, first and foremost, I want to congratulate you for making it to the end of the video. Wow, what an amazing week my wife and I had in Punta Cana. There's a reason why we go back there year after year. But let's talk about when you stuck around till the end of the video for the Grand Palladium Bávaro. Should you stay there? Is it a place that Monica and I would visit again? I had a hard time with this one because there were a lot of things that I loved about the hotel. But there were a few things, major things to me at least, that would make or break whether I would stay here again. Let's talk about the positives first. One of the biggest positives are the grounds, the tropical flower and fauna, the palm trees. I love that. And to wander through, get up each morning, head to the gym, head to the beach, and be surrounded by all that tropical beauty, it really made you feel that you were smack dab in the middle of the Caribbean, not just at any all-inclusive like in Cancun where it's just a concrete monolith and buildings, and yes, you have the beach, but not the tropical grounds that the Grand Palladium had. And the nice thing was that where we were staying at the Bávaro, which is the oldest of the four hotels, it was built in 1992, that added to the tropical atmosphere because the palms were fully mature, really large. All the vegetation had years and years to develop. Something that we didn't find at other all-inclusives in Punta Cana in past stays. So I really like that a lot. The food was not bad. I have to be honest with you. We enjoyed all the buffets. La Paisana of the a la carte restaurants, La Paisana was our favorite. We went to eat at La Lola, the tapas restaurant. I didn't showcase that in the video because it was just so-so. We're Spanish, so we're a little bit more critical about tapas and things like that. And the hibachi grill, we ate there. That was kind of like food from the buffet that they put on a show for at the hibachi restaurant. So in those categories, the food was just okay. But the rest of the time, the buffets and all that, we thought it was pretty good. And the other thing, the beach was impeccable. The beach was beautiful. And like I mentioned in the video, the Bávaro had the best beach out of all the hotels. If you went down a little further, next to us was the Punta Cana. That beach was all worn away. It was very narrow. And then the palace, that beach didn't even exist practically. And the TRS Turquesa, honestly, I didn't go to that beach, so I can't really comment on that. And they kept the beaches clean, free of seaweed, which the other hotels next to us just left the seaweed there. And like I said in the video, that's part of, you're a guest. Even though the beaches are public, these hotels, these all-inclusive hotels, should be taking care of the seaweed. I know it's a problem that we're encountering with global warming and all that, but the Bávaro and all the hotels, the Palace, the Punta Cana, the Tierras Turquesas, kept all the seaweed off the beach each morning. But it was a constant battle because it replenished the very next day. And then finally, another positive, which may be a negative to some people, was the sheer size and scale of this resort. It afforded you so many dining and drinking and entertainment options, which made it so much fun. Yes, there was a lot of walking you had to do, but they had these trains that if you wanted to, you could hop on them and it would take you across the four hotels. We rarely used them. We like to exercise and walk and get our steps in and that kind of stuff. And like I said, I love tropical plants, as you can see here on my rooftop deck. So it was an opportunity for me to walk along and study and see what I had, what I didn't have, like I said in the beginning of the video. Okay, now let's talk about the negatives. And the biggest, most glaring negative for me were the rooms here at the Grand Palladium. We had a superior room. I upgraded. I slipped a little extra money to the front desk and got into a premium room. Not what I expected. The rooms were dark, dank, almost had like some sort of like French bordello vibe. Not that I've ever been to a French bordello, but if you could imagine such a place, that's what it was like. You came back to the room, the smell was moldy, mildewy, or on some days when you came back, depending on who had just checked in to your left or right, the whole room reeked of marijuana. So we didn't like that. And the staff, not the entire staff, but the cleaning staff, were not very friendly. They were sort of, like I said, amargado, a little pissed off all the time. We had a huge pillow that my wife couldn't sleep on, and we asked the girl to change the pillow for us very nicely. And she's like, "What room?" And, you know, we came back later on, 4 or 5 in the afternoon, and the same pillow was there. And the room wasn't clean. That was another thing. They didn't always keep up on cleaning the room. And when they did clean the room, it was very rushed and sloppy. You could see the mop streaks still all over the floor. Any fine hotel would never allow that. So they need to work on that. They need to work on that a bit. All right, another glaring negative for me were the swimming pools here at the resort. Let's talk about the swimming pools. They were fairly old. They needed to be redone and remodeled, that's for sure. And then the other thing was, they just weren't inviting. They were filled with kids. And I realized we weren't in the adult section, the TRS Turquesa. But it just made you not want to get in the pools because kids were at the pool bar, splashing everywhere. So we spent most of our time on the beach, which was fine. We like that. And I will say, the standout pools at the hotel were the pool at the Zentropia Spa, which was excellent. Oh my God, that was the best pool. And there was a secret pool that we didn't get to, located more toward the TRS Turquesa. I did pass by that, and that also looked very tranquil and very relaxing. I think it stayed open till midnight. Next time, if we stay there, next time we will stay at the TRS Turquesa and enjoy that pool, definitely. All right, so let's wrap this up before I go on and on. Who's this hotel for? And would Monica and I stay there again? This hotel is for families with kids, I would say, with the exception of the TRS Turquesa. Monica and I don't have kids. We want to go for fun at the pool, fun on the beach, those sorts of things. And it was a hard thing to do, at the pools at least. The kids were everywhere. They were even at the swim-up bar, which is weird to me. And the other thing was the rooms, they need to be remodeled. They have to be remodeled to be brighter, more vibrant. And finally, I would say the staff. The staff, they weren't the friendliest, and they weren't the most helpful, which we found at other all-inclusives in Punta Cana not to be the case. If you called the front desk, forget about it. Nobody ever answered. If you needed a ride to get to a restaurant or a lobby, that didn't happen. That was not going to happen. And if you wanted a simple switch, like the pillow situation, it went in one ear and out the other. So I think that's another glaring negative that we didn't like. So in the end, would we stay here again? I don't think so. Unless they remodel the rooms, have a pep talk with the staff about being, you know, with smiles and friendlier. And finally, the pools. The pools need to be totally remodeled. If they did that, then Monica and I would stay here again at the Grand Palladium Bávaro Punta Cana Palace or the TRS Turquesa. Probably that's where we'll stay next time, the TRS Turquesa, just to be in the adults only section. All right, so I hope you enjoyed the video. Hopefully you'll subscribe and put a like. I really appreciate you watching, and congratulations for making it to the end. I know it was a very long video, and I will see you on the next one. All right, take care.